cinematic. Everyone wants cinematic. And to be honest with you guys, I don't even know what that means, cinematic. Really, what does that mean? This word has been thrown around for quite a while now. And I don't even know if it means the look. Is it a LUT that you apply on your video? Is it bars? What is it? I don't even know. But today, we're gonna try to get that Black Pro Mist look in Final Cut Pro. If you've done photography for a while, or maybe even cinematography, you must have heard the word halation. That's the name of the effect. So we're gonna go to Final Cut Pro today, and I'm gonna show you guys two different ways on how to make this effect. So the first thing we need to do is to isolate the highlights. And then we're gonna add the effect. To isolate the highlights, we're going to duplicate the clip and then add the Luma Keyer effect. So go to Effects, Keying, Luma Keyer. We're gonna remove all the dark areas of this duplicate right here. So the way to do that is we have to drag this handle to the right. You can click on one of these three icons right here to see the effect. So when you click on the one in the middle, you will see that the parts that are white are the parts that are visible, and the ones that are in black are not visible. So play around with the handles to fine-tune your selection. If you want to smoothen the transition of the effect, all you have to do is to drag the Luma roll-off to the right, and you will create a curve up here. Check this out. That's gonna make the effect less harsh and create this transition from the highlights to the mid-tones. Now the next step is to add the Gaussian blur effect. So go to Effect, Blur, Gaussian Blur, and there's the effect we're looking for. But of course it looks like it's too much right now, so let's reduce the intensity by reducing the amount, the blur amount. You know what? It's even better to start at zero and then you gradually add the effect so that you're not gonna be tempted to overdo it. And to fine-tune the effect, you can also play around with the opacity of this duplicate clip right here. And there you go. Subtle, but nice. And the second method is probably even easier. This time, you don't even have to duplicate the clip. You just need to add the Gaussian blur on that clip. Although, I highly recommend you still create a duplicate just in case you mess up something in that main clip. Duplicate the clip, and let's add a Gaussian blur on that clip. And then click on Mask, and add color mask. Let's zoom in so that we can use the color picker to select the highlights and then adjust the selection. So click on the highlights and then let's adjust the selection. And when you're satisfied with the selection, adjust the intensity again with the amount slider or maybe with the opacity, if you duplicated the clip, of course. And that's it. If you guys got value from this video, go check out these tips for Final Cut Pro users. And I will see you guys in the next one.